In fact, our guys have just taken down one of the migrant guys right here on the corner, 42nd and 7th, while all
this is
taking.
Can you pan the camera?
They've taken over. They've taken over. He is out of control. Out of control.
There. All right, now. So you might recall from earlier this week, we talked about that incident that happened live on Fox News on Sean Hannity's program. Curtis Sliwa, the man in the beret right there, and his guardian angels accosted a migrant who had been shoplifting. And there was reason to believe that perhaps some of those facts were not true. Well, none of them were, actually. It's a Bronx resident, there was no shoplifting. And Sean Hannity just broadcast to the nation live an assault on a person by right-wingers, right-wing vigilantes in the streets of New York assaulting someone. So there was no immediate apology. In fact, Sean Hannity waited more than a full day to say anything about what he did. And when it came, this is the entirety of it.
Now, before we go tonight, I want to talk about Curtis Sliwa's appearance on this show on Tuesday night when members of the Guardian Angels stopped a man and the police were called. Now, Curtis said that the man was a migrant and that he was shoplifting. Fox News has since spoken to the NYPD. Apparently, the statements made by Curtis that the man is a migrant is not true, and the man was given a summons for disorderly conduct. Now, today, Curtis Sliwa acknowledged to the Washington Post that the man has not been charged with shoplifting, and Curtis said, in part, quote, "I shouldn't have been listening to the crowd. That was my mistake. I should not have had that knee-jerk reaction." Again, on this show, we always want to set the record straight.
But did you? Did you? You waited a full day. And rather than, I don't know, maybe like lead off with the fact that you perhaps made history by featuring live vigilante justice on your show, you decided to fit it in the last literally 50 seconds of your program. And when you, did you notice, by the way, there was nothing in there that even charitably could be described as an apology for doing this. You'll remember, he did not push back in any way. As the assault was being broadcast over his shoulder, you know how like we play B-roll, sometimes we play the aliens spinning around or whatever. He had a person of color being beaten on the streets of New York, and he talked about how Biden had let in tons of immigrants. That's what he did instead of maybe like questioning the guy or saying, hey, maybe don't brutalize someone live on my show. And all we got was, this guy Curtis Lee was wrong, it wasn't a migrant. He wasn't shoplifting. Here's a follow-up question, Sean Hannity. What if he was a migrant, and what if he had been shoplifting? Would it be okay then? Are you actually implying that a guy who committed a minor property crime, that you are then allowed to brutalize him? You're allowed to commit a violent crime against him. Well, if that's the case, then I don't know. I just saw live on TV someone committing a violent crime. Can another person who sees that beat them? Would you broadcast that? Where does this end when you decide that you're gonna deputize random people who happen to own berets to start beating people that they think look suspicious and that they think are migrants because in their own words, they heard them speaking Spanish. In New York City, that was the only qualification that was necessary. You think all of this is appropriate. You didn't apologize for any of it. I don't know if he broke any laws. It kind of feels like there should be something bordering on criminality and doing PR for a group like this. And the final thing I will say is not only did he not question Curtis Sliwa live on the air, but he allowed him on his show in the first place. And it's weird that it ended up that he lied about the nature of a crime to make it look like he was cleaning the streets. When if you had done a little bit of research into Curtis Sliwa, back in the 90s, he had to admit that he made up 6 different incidents where his guardian angels would foil crimes as publicity that didn't actually happen. He's been doing this for literally decades, and Sean Hannity, the useful idiot, let him do it live on TV in 2024. Sharon, I want to start with you. What do you think about this?
That's bad theater, and you and I talked about that this week. Bad theater. Curtis is ridiculous, and so are the other red beret wearers that night. And if you can believe it, after everything else, and by the way, I think that Sean Hannity apologized, if you want to call it that, only because the lawsuit's coming, if it hasn't already been discussed, and is going back and forth. And so he kind of said, okay, maybe we'll just moonwalk back a little bit. But at the end of the day here, they didn't know if this man was asking for directions or hitting the corner deli to get a pack of Swiss cheese. And they behaved like buffoons. And they're still at it tonight, okay? Tonight's headline is, the Guardian Angels have now filed a criminal complaint against the man they assaulted and had no right to assault, saying he's very angry, very aggressive. Okay, that's just part of what they said in the Daily News. And he pushed one of them. What would you do if you were minding your own business and these guys who are all dressed alike started running up to you and throwing hands? Would you be angry? Would you be a little aggressive? I don't know, it's just a question.
Maybe you'd feel you have to defend yourself as you're being accosted live on TV by a mob.
Don't get crazy.
Listen, lest we forget, I descend from people who swung from poplar trees in the South, right? The idea that a mob can attack people of color because they committed a crime that was made up by that mob hits me a different way. It felt like in 2024, I'm watching a lynching and I heard a national TV anchor said, can you pan the camera? This is nothing more than highlighting and publishing the maiming and beating of people of color in 2024 America. We should be reminded that we are not that far removed from when people are lynched and people watch it in entertainment fashion. This is absolutely disgusting. The fact that they are celebrating and highlighting this, I hope the person that was assaulted is calling a lawyer to call Fox News to answer for this.
And the prosecutor, I think charges, you got me riled up, Mayor. Charges are in order here, not just a, made a mistake.
I'm gonna end with this. I don't know, you know, the entire membership of the organization. I don't know, maybe there's some people that think they're joining up with something that they've sort of heard about and maybe they can do some good or whatever. I don't know. I don't know what the motivations of every individual is. I just know what Curtis Sliwa wants the group to be right now. I know what he is trying, what role he is trying to have it play in our political system. The alliance that he has with Sean Hannity, the willingness he has to dispatch his members after people because they speak Spanish and look suspicious. So I don't know the people in this organization, but I would say you now know what Curtis Sliwa wants the organization to be. Maybe rethink your membership, perhaps.
Thanks for watching the video, guys. We also love it if you hit the join button below because that makes you a member. And members allow us to be independent, honest. We could be as progressive as we want, no corporate media influence. And that's all because of you guys. We love doing the show with our members. Hit the join button, become one of the Young Turks.